Hello, amazing humans in the universe. So, wanted to jump on and talk about, I think, an extremely popular subject within the Neville and manifesting community. And yet, I think also we need to deep dive into some misconceptions and also some, I believe, powerful techniques that can help you, which is the SP, the special person, the significant person. Right now, first and foremost, let's talk about that term, okay? Because again, neuroscience shows that we don't do well with abstract concepts, okay? So for example, why is it that at the beginning of every single year, you have a spike in gym memberships, and by the end of February or early March, you have a drop, a dip? Because the brain doesn't understand abstract. The brain doesn't get it. So when you use the term SP and you call that special person or that significant person SP, you will ensure that you probably will not manifest them. Now, why is that? Because the brain doesn't like abstract information. So what am I saying that you should do? First and foremost, you want to give them a name. You want to name them their name. Whatever that is. And usually, if you're in any relationship, let's say you're using some of these techniques to get one back, usually if you've been in a relationship longer than 5 minutes, you might even have a nickname for each other. So use that nickname, because that's the nickname that you would have used had you been still in a relationship with them, right? So again, use people's names. The brain will not help you at all if you continue using 3P and SP and all of this kind of special jargon, right? Now, let's really, really deep dive into this, okay? Because what is the deep desire behind wanting an SP if you don't have one or trying to get one back? One, it's to eradicate loneliness. Two, to feel loved. Three, to not feel like you are rejectable, like that somehow you have deep, deep, inherent, natural value. So what do we do with that? Well, those are all hints, big hints at what you should really be manifesting for. But not just manifesting, who you yourself should be embodying, who you yourself should be becoming, okay? So if you want to be the person who gets your significant other back, then you should embody those new qualities every single day. Every single day, live from that state. Live within that state as if it's like a piece of clothing, right? Explore it from the inside. What does it feel like to be a person who isn't rejected? Because that's extremely powerful. When you feel like you can't be rejected no matter what you do, power is the first thing that you feel, and then worth, and then self-worth. And then and then deep, deep inherent value comes in and you're like, I don't need anybody. Now, this is not some technique to push away your SP, but this is actually to give you the qualities that you're seeking in the other, which, by the way, is nothing more than a mirror. So if they're a mirror, take that, not as a negative, but as a, oh, okay, so I need to use this as a way to explore my inner world and see where I've hidden these beliefs that make me think that I need a man or a woman to make me feel important. No, I'm important with or without a person. I am, and I can be, and I can enjoy being alone, right? So when you love your own company, when you love yourself, okay, this is when you will encounter your SP, whether it be your first time, second time, or you're getting somebody back after, you know, a failed marriage. Whatever it is, this is the key. You create scenes from the first person and you saturate them with 3 to 5 emotions. And usually you want to create 3 to 5 scenes. This technique is very different than most other Neville Goddard coaches. Why? Because neuroscience shows a few things. That one, our brain goes through affective fatigue, which means your brain gets bored of having and experiencing just one of the same emotions over and over again. Okay. So that's why you want to choose 3 to 5 emotions. And every single scene, and this isn't just with your SP, that you're creating, that you want to saturate your mind with, should also include nostalgia. Every single scene for the rest of your life. At least one of those five emotions should be nostalgia. Why? Because that's Neville's technique of I remember when. Okay. And so what you want to do is you want to sit and marinate. I love the word marinate because it just means you're living in it, right? And so you're living in that emotion and you're drenched in it. And that's Neville's term, right? And you are saturated to the point of like, man, this feels good. Like, this just feels great. Then walk into your scene, giving yourself just one physical action to repeat over and over again while you're generating all of this emotional energy behind it. Practice that again and again and again. Okay? And you'll know if you've actually saturated your subconscious, because if you wake up the next day and you're still asking, do I have it? Then you haven't done it yet. That's not condemnation. That is not for you to feel guilty. Just do it again and do it again and do it again. Do it from a state of deserving. Because here's the thing. If you are trying to manifest somebody that you love or that loves you or whatever the circumstance might be, you want to be in a state of acceptance, not rejection. Okay? Because what will happen is you might even get lucky and actually manifest them. But then a year down the line, 10 years down the line, you will then end up manifesting them leaving you or you leaving them, whatever it might be. So again, if you're looking for sustained relationship, then feel that sustained relationship within yourself to yourself. What does that mean? Well, here's a quick tip and then I'm gonna let you go. Is you wanna romanticize your relationship with your inner self. That should always be above and beyond anything else or anybody else or any desire. You romanticize means I'm going to now set aside a time during my day, every single day or night, both if it works for your schedule, and begin working on feeling connected. Just literally just feel connected, feel joy, feel romantic feelings. This is why you have the Song of Solomon in the Bible. It's a massive psychological metaphor of the inner self having a relationship with the outer self, right? Sex is a metaphor for intimacy and connection and union. So you want to practice that. And I guarantee you, you don't even have to effort anything else because you believe you're God. It'll just come naturally to you, right? So again, there's more on this. There's more to this. And this is a bit messy and chaotic, but I wanted to jump on here because I know that we're coming up to Valentine's Day, and I know there's a lot of lonely people, right? Do not take that label on. You're not lonely. You're loved. You're accepted. You're awesome. You're beautiful. All of those things are already true of you. So embrace that. Live that. Breathe that. Embody that, because you deserve that. Thank you very, very much. Hope this was helpful. Please leave some comments below. Share this with at least one person. Hit that bell, you know, do it. Love you all, and until next time, bye.